On the item card in Business Central, you have actions in the ribbon, which are relevant for salespeople, and I will just run through those here. So for instance, on my actions, I have the special prices and discount menu, and from that I can set special prices, discounts, and get an overview of both of them. So special price is a specific price that I can set per customer, per unit of measure, etc. I will show you later. So a special price is a specific price you can define, and a special discount is a percentage discount you can define per item, per customer or customer price group. So here I can define that either a specific customer, a price group, all customer, a campaign with whatever code, meaning a customer 20,000 for instance, when buying this item in pieces with a minimum quantity of 20, should pay 4,000 crowns or whatever it is, and I can define starting date and ending date, etc. And in this view, the system will automatically find the best fitting price for the customer when creating sales order lines. And here I can filter this view by item number, sales code filter, etc. So if I open from a customer perspective, I see the same window but with a sales code filter on the customer, and I can see all the items that this customer is buying. So with this functionality, I can set up very specific prices. And likewise, on my actions, I have my special price discount, and I can set up that the same customer, when buying this item again, will get a line discount of 10%. Normally, of course, I wouldn't do both. I would do either one or the other. And I can see if it had earlier, maybe this is the old way of doing it in my perspective. So I could say this was working last year if I had data like this. And if I go to my discounts overview, I can see both of them. So this is just an overview of both my prices and my discounts. From my navigation tab, I can go into my entries, and the entries specifically relevant for salespeople will be the reservation entry. So if I use reservation and reserve coming supply or existing inventory up against sales order lines, I can see in the entries here which reservation that I have. From availability function, I can go into items by location and see my inventory per location. In this example, I only have inventory on one location, but with this functionality, it's possible to see on all my items what location I have which quantities. And from my navigate sales function, I can set up prepayment percentages. So I can define again per customer or customer price group, all customers on this item number within a specific date interval. I could set up that a prepayment percentage is necessary, meaning that they will have to pay some part of the amount before we actually ship the goods. That is set up in here. And from navigation sales, I can see orders and returns orders, and both of them is just a list of sales order lines with the specific item number that I can see on which order documents they are and for which customers. And the same list goes for sales return orders. And last of all, from navigate on my bill of material, I can define if it's an assembly item, I can use the functionality here, calculate unit price, to calculate my unit price based on the standard cost that is calculated on the assembly order.